Xiang, a marketing engineer of Advanced Technologies, and I will talk about the measurement challenges for DVB-T and DVB-T2 receivers. DVB-T is the most widely deployed terrestrial digital video standard, and DVB-T2 is an enhancement system of it. In this video, I'm going to show you some examples for DVB-T2 receiver performance tests using Advanced instruments. Our demo instruments include two signal generators, MXG. One is used for DVB-T2 wanted signal, and the other is used for the interfering signal. This demo also includes a commercial DVB-T2 set-top box with a TV for video display and a signal analyzer, MXA, to monitor signal.
The first thing I would like to do is to give you an overview of the N7623B Signal Studio for digital video. In the format, we can see the different standards supported. In this example, we use a DVB-T2 signal and we can set parameters like bandwidths, PRPs, modulation type, guard interval, and so on. We are going to use the default setting with two PRPs, which is a common use case. The stream file used here is a TS file. An MPEG-2 TS file can be loaded as payload, which can be stored on the hard disk of the PC or the MXG.
Now, let's use the signal analyzer to measure the quality of the transmitted signal. On the signal analyzer, we can see the rotated constellations of the DVB-T2 signal, and the MER measured is about 48 dB. And we can view the video stream on the TV. The stream is played very smoothly.
Next, let's add AWGN to the DVB-T2 signal and implement the carrier-to-noise ratio performance test in the Gaussian channel. Set the signal-to-noise ratio to a large value such as 25 dB, and then decrease the signal-to-noise ratio and monitor the display. By doing this, we can see that when signal-to-noise ratio is decreased to 18.9 dB, the video stream is frozen in the form of a mosaic. This is the carrier to noise ratio we want to measure. We also.
I'm Feng Xiang, a marketing engineer of Advanced Technologies, and I will talk about the measurement challenges for DVB-T and DVB-T2 receivers. DVB-T is the most widely deployed terrestrial digital video standard, and DVB-T2 is an enhancement system of it. In this video, I'm going to show you some examples for DVB-T2 receiver performance tests using Advanced instruments. Our demo instruments include two signal generators, MXG. One is used for DVB-T2 wanted signal, and the other is used for the interfering signal. This demo also includes a commercial DVB-T2 set-top box with a TV for video display and a signal analyzer, MXA, to monitor signal.
The first thing I would like to do is to give you an overview of the N7623B Signal Studio for digital video. In the format, we can see the different standards supported. In this example, we use a DVB-T2 signal and we can set parameters like bandwidths, PRPs, modulation type, guard interval, and so on. We are going to use the default setting with two PRPs, which is a common use case. The stream file used here is a TS file. An MPEG-2 TS file can be loaded as payload, which can be stored on the hard disk of the PC or the MXG.
Now, let's use the signal analyzer to measure the quality of the transmitted signal. On the signal analyzer, we can see the rotated constellations of the DVB-T2 signal, and the MER measured is about 48 dB. And we can view the video stream on the TV. The stream is played very smoothly.
Next, let's add AWGN to the DVB-T2 signal and implement the carrier to noise ratio performance test in the Gaussian channel. Set the signal to noise ratio to a large value such as 25 dB and then decrease the signal to noise ratio and monitor the display. By doing this, we can